Hello and welcome to the first in a series of videos which is going to look at the requirements for OCR's AS Media Studies course. The course is split into three units, two of which are assessed by a two-hour written examination which comprises of 50% of the total mark, and then a further practical unit wherein students create their own media product, and that's also worth 50%. In these videos we're only really going to be dealing with the areas of study that are exam based, and we're going to start off looking at the four key concepts which govern the study of medias. First of these is representation, which is often related to ideas about stereotyping. The next is media language, then audience and institutions. Your understanding of representation and how media language is used to inform it will be assessed in Section A of the exam. Audiences and institutions are assessed in Section B. Representation refers literally to how different elements of society are portrayed in the media. In the case of this specific unit, you'll look at how they are portrayed in British television drama. So, for example, you may be shown a clip of anything from Waterloo Road to Doctor Who, and then asked about how various characters, types of characters, are portrayed in it. So we had recent extracts in the exam looking at the portrayal of women from the drama Merlin, and then most recently the portrayal of the disabled was looked at. The manner in which these portrayals are constructed links us into the other key concept assessed in Section A of the exam, which is media language. We'll go into more detail about these areas explored in the representation unit in a later tutorial, but for now we'll look quickly at how the concept of media language links in with it. Media language is a term which frequently confuses students, but if you're able to get your head around the concept at an early stage, it won't simply make your A-level studies considerably less perplexing. It will mean that you'll be able to, as the OCR specification requires, and I'm quoting from Assessment Objective 1 here, to write using terminology appropriately and with accurate and coherent written expression. The ability to discuss media language fluently is what will push you from the merely proficient into excellent. And that's the difference between C's and B's and A's and A stars. Put simply, media language refers to the methods used by producers of different media, whether they are the producers of television shows, newspapers, or video games. It's all about how they create meaning. The use of the term language is what seems to cause the most consternation for students, but you should just look at it like this. When you study English, writers use words to create meaning. With non-fiction texts, other devices come into play, like presentational features, different types of sentence structures, paragraphs, sections, etc., etc. In our particular area of study, which is the visual media, what we are talking about is analysing how media is constructed in film and television. And in very basic terms, this is done through the careful selection of camera shots, and of course what goes inside the camera shot, so how the image is composed within the frame, where the actors are placed, how they move towards one another or away from one another, the props, the lighting, the costumes, all of this that comes under the heading of mise-en-scene. This is all how meaning is created within the frame. And then these are arranged together in the editing process to create even more meaning. This is, of course, enhanced with sound, so your dialogue, your music, your sound effects. In Section A of your exam, you'll be analysing how a particular section of society, women, racial minorities, the working class, disabled people, how they're portrayed, how they're represented. And that'll be done by you being shown a short clip, which you then have to analyse in relation to its representation of one particular section of society. So the way that portrayal will be created, and what will allow you to understand the inherent meaning behind a particular representation, will be your understanding of how the media language used in television works. It's worth noting in that in reality, television language is merely a watered-down version of what is called film language. They both refer to how meaning is created visually. However, due to the fact that there are other options of study on this course, not just moving pictures, the exam board has to use the more general term media language in order to encompass all the different areas for studies. In the next tutorial, we will look at the key concepts of audience and institutions. Thanks for listening.